Hello everybody, my name is Raylazor and welcome back to Ring of Fates. In the last episode, we took down Abyss's Forest and today we're working over to Rela Cyel. Before you do that though, I would recommend you stock up on healing items, so that's what I'm going to be doing here. And that's mainly because the boss of that area is very tedious. So that's something to keep in mind. Let's stock up and there we are. Let's go! Yeah! I'm pretty sure I sold some of my Magicites in the last video. I'm not sure. It's going to be okay though. Rela Cyel is fairly short, and hopefully we can keep it that way. As you can tell, the bridge is broken here, so we won't be able to cross. Instead, we're gonna have to hop over on a bunch of debris here. Something that we can bypass once we get on the other side, but there's no real point. That last jump right there gets annoying though, because you don't really know where you're going to land on. So let's activate this switch and that'll make us a bridge. Or a platform. Yeah, that's good enough. Alright. We're not done yet though, since you can see that there's an enemy on the dead center of the mini-map. So instead, let's walk on the outside rim here. And since we're a Selkie, we can double jump over the platform. If you're not, you can just jump from the side like so. But there's a few item boxes here and there, and we can get towards that enemy soon enough. I think you might need a Selkie for that though. Anyways, we get our first item, the Ice Covenant. I believe this improves your ice-based spell attacks, something we don't really need to worry about as a Selkie. And we got a Band of Rebirth, which is something that I might tamper with in the future. Not too sure yet. I'm preferring skill rings or power rings. And I believe that scroll right there would give you a life ring, so we'll just have to see how that goes once we're done with the video. Anyways, we're all the way around, so now we can hop up on top. And while we can only see one enemy, there's actually a bunch around here, so be careful when you're spawning them. They're all bomb enemies, so is this guy gonna turn? Okay, oh, there we go. Make sure you're careful around them, because they're dangerous. More dangerous than most enemies, at least. As a Selkie, you can definitely approach them with a tribal ability, but there is a tendency of having a few of them spawn at once, and they're also a little bit annoying with their spells sometimes. On the bright side, this guy is out of our aggro range, or we're out of his aggro range, so we won't have to worry about that. Let's go for some more long-range snipes. There we are. Would rather not get too close to them, and we already have a pretty decent attack power for our abilities, so if I can avoid having them hit me, I'll just do that. So far nothing too much to worry about. The barrel on the center is nothing important, it's just a barrel full of recovery items here, so get some of those if you did not stock up enough, for whatever reason, if you may have been a little bit short on funds or stingy with your items. Alright, there we go, nice. Charge attacks are always lovely, but I think that's about it, so we can finally get deep down into the actual building. And here, everything is run down and covered in moss. There's also a bunch of goblins, and I would recommend you avoid the center of the area until you've cleared out the outer rim. Something to keep in mind, and this guy is pretty aggressive, so hopefully we can kill him anytime soon. We're actually pretty low on health and I'm in danger. Oh god, I got myself killed. Oh jeez. Oh, okay, well. Listen, we've already cleared out the outside, so that's nothing to worry about. We'll hop back on in and we'll avoid the outer rim this time because that's not exactly necessary. The game does keep track of your EXP and items collected even if you do die, so that's nothing to worry about. Instead, let's just move straight on in and hopefully not get killed by a goblin. That was a risky move there that I played around with. Or just trying to play the devils. Play the devil? Play the roulette, there we go. Don't think the devil is interested in me playing with him. Alright, got our level up. And a few items lying around here, nothing to worry about. Working around here, you'll have a few items and a bunch of goblins and turtle. Shell turtles, armor turtles, spiked creatures, tortoise shell thingy mabobs. Who knows? We'll find them. I don't really notice any official terms. And it's apparent that there's only goblins here. I was certain that there are turtle enemies around here. There certainly are some in Rela Cyel, so that's nothing to worry about. We'll encounter one or two of them eventually. Let's work our ways around and go to the other side of the rim of this mini-map before we move towards the center. Alright, get that. Not much in terms of resources. Now, dead center here, we can spawn in one of those sentry thingies. Spiders, robot. And what I'd like to do is basically hide behind here and use my tribal ability. They're a little bit annoying to deal with, so I prefer to stay far back, and they do have a few ranged attacks, which often gets blocked by this little barricade we have here, which is pretty beneficial. And that way we won't have to worry about losing too much health. Something that I have apparently already done, which is why we got a game over earlier. Anyways, let's move down here. We don't have to worry about that platform, since everything's already been destroyed, really. And you'll notice this entire area is flooded. We have some Sahagans here, and one of the best tactics to deal with them is to actually jump on them while they're still in water. Well, they can hit you and knock you off into the water. They do a lot less damage. As you can tell, it's not very aggressive now that we're here. But if they manage to get out, they have a tendency of using a huge range of attacks and being pretty aggressive. Now, we're going to split this mini-map here into two parts. So we're going to cover the right side first, and then go over to the left side to kill the left side enemies. And we'll take care of this golem so we can get at this chest. There we are. And what's in here? Alright, we got a scroll, a dragon-like helm, that's nice. And I think I want to recover my SP first, there we are. Let's use another one, there we go. Alright, switch back to our health magicite, yeah. And over here you'll notice this entire area is flooded. I recommend checking the right side first, since we will be draining the water in this area, and that means you won't be able to access the next area unless you're silky. This platform jump right here is a little bit annoying because sometimes you miss. I guess going from this way is a lot better. There we are. More Sahagans, which I'm not too worried about their loot since we're going through this area for two runs. So I'll just stand right here, and as you can tell, very little spell casting, very little destructive things. A little bit annoying that it spawns you back here, so we'll just do a quick double jump. I want to see if I can get that. I cannot. And there we go, it sinks into the depths. Okay, well it'll despawn later, nothing to worry about. Let's hop right up here and we'll encounter three chests. Let's take care of this plant right here first. There we go. I'm pretty sure I remembered its name in the last video, but I've already forgotten about that, so nothing to worry about. There we go, it goes down. A few more healing supplies. You're gonna need all of them, really. And we can break these three chests, all which contain scrolls. So there we go, a few more items, and we got a Sahagan up on land now, so this means it's a little bit annoying. Now it's able to block, do quick melee attacks, cast spells, and just be a nuisance, really. We got lucky with that stun there, though, so that's good news. And I think this guy's probably gonna jump off the water, too. If not, I'll land in the water and miss twice. Great. Alright, let's just stand right here. I'm gonna heal, just for good measures, since I don't want another goblin accident to happen again. Alright, there we go. I'm gonna try to catch that item. Alright, we got a Sahagan fin, which is good news because those things are monster unique drops. There we are. And that's not where the platform was. Okay, let's try this again. But that's pretty much all we need here. Great place to get a quick few set of items if you need them. But otherwise, you can actually avoid this entire area in general and just move to the left side. So that's what we're going to do now. We'll avoid the monsters that we just killed. And the left side is generally pretty similar to the right side. There's another goblin with a chest, another Sahagan, but the doorway in is a little bit different. And if I can actually land on this guy, there we go. Hopefully we'll be able to kill him and move on with our lives. So that's one of the things I was talking about getting knocked off. Now, when you ever get knocked in the water, if you're playing alongside, I recommend mashing your jump button or whatever your button is in order to make sure that you don't land flat. I don't know how to say this. You don't want to land laying down because then you can get chain comboed and you can die pretty easily because of that. If you mash your jump button in time, you'll be able to just come back to the surface standing up, and that'll let you avoid getting attacked again. This will make more sense once we actually deal with the actual boss fight, where this has a tendency of happening. In the meantime, let's just take care of what we have in front of us. And what we're working towards right now is the control switch to lower the water levels. We can also move over to this side. And there we go. There's a barrel right there that we can get at. And I believe there's supplies in this as well. Yep, stuff that we don't really need to worry about right now since we got a plentiful stock. So let's move on. And I think this is where we deal with the turtles, a little bit up ahead. I know for a fact there's at least one turtle up there, and if there isn't, I'm going to be very confused. Alright. So far so good, let's move up here, and I'm going to prepare a charge attack because these turtles can be annoying. There we go. Fire a shot off, run back here, and do this again. They have a tendency of interrupting your attacks very easily. They have a lot of defenses, blocks, just a bunch of annoying measures that you definitely don't want to deal with. So it's best to kill them as fast as possible. By unlocking this, we lower the water level and we unlock one of the entrances below. So we can go in here, but I'm not going to because there's another pathway that we can take that will lead to more loot and other stuff. So basically, we're going to be working back to the lobby and to the right entrance this time. The place where we just got our 3 chest worths of equipment. And that way, we'll be able to get a height advantage, so to say. Alongside this, by moving over here, we can actually grab a few items here. 2 chests laying around and a few monsters. Oh my god! That thing has some crazy legs for a fish monster, jeez. Take it easy, buddy. I don't want to die already. Alright. As you can see, very annoying on the surface with her attacks. There we go. Oh, okay. And that little jitter motion was basically its block. In case you fired a shot off at it immediately. Very annoying. Got another one right here, but this time we're going to land you before you can do anything so you can't block yourself. There we go. Ooh, we got hit though. Not too much to worry about though. Okay. Can I get at that item? Got a piece of silver. Worth it. Alright. Don't even know how to swim. Selkies! Selkies, oddly enough, don't know how to swim. I know they're forest-based creatures, but if you ever searched up the term Selkie by itself, apparently it's some sort of like seal mermaid that turns into a seal in the water and a girl on land. Listen, that has to be a coincidence because, those names are far too different. Anyways, let's move on over to the right side. You'll also notice that the lobby is less flooded now. Not really too much of an improvement. We'll be able to check out the whole extent of this area in the future when we're going to Rela Cyel Pass, but you know what? I'm not even going to be fighting that enemy. I'm not interested. You can't access the elevator shaft here, and by the way, that's an elevator shaft, so we can worry about that in the future as well. So let's move on into the right entrance. And here we get the height advantage. We got a goblin to deal with, nothing to worry about. And basically that doorway down there where that Sahagin is where we would have entered through if we went into the doorway right below the control panel or the control switch. Oh, saying these words, not my day. Okay, well, let's heal up our SP values real quick. And now we can just inch our way a little bit closer. There we go, and there's one of those robots. Once again, want to have the height advantage. I think I can still get hit from this. But it's a lot better since these guys apparently can't jump. It's for the best. These sentries would probably put dents into the ground. So, also they would probably put dents into me. So, it's a lot better to just have the height advantage. There we go. We can also do the same attacks with the Sahagins. But I'm going to opt not to simply because these guys can pull out some serious shenanigans when they're on land. So we'll just attack and approach these guys the regular way. Try not to destroy that barrel or else you'll have to re-enter the area and deal with all these monsters again. And now that I'm in danger, I'm just gonna inch my way back here real quick so I can recover. Another benefit of starting with a height advantage so you're not immediately pelted with a bunch of enemies. There we go, and let's use a potion since we have that pocket maxed out right now. Alright. Approach this area once more, and we're gonna get a level up with a quick critical hit. Fantastic. Alright, let's grab this barrel here and make sure you don't accidentally throw it. Just drop it on the ground. Activating this switch will let us get a key to put into this other switch. And this will unlock the door to proceed. Break these barrels. There we go. All 3 at once. More supplies if you're interested. We're pretty much stock full, so I don't think I have to worry a single bit about this. There we go. And save point. Unfortunately, you can't read these books because you're busy firing arrows into them. Something to keep in mind. But we can spot our friendly Moogle friend right up here, hiding behind this ceramic pot, and stack of books. You found me, Kupo. Allow me to give you a commemorative stamp. Kupo, right now, I feel like putting my stamp here. Kupo, alright, there we go. Kupo, got it. Let's move on. Alright, and this area is generally reserved for Lotis because this is where the tutorial would activate, as you can tell with the spikes and stuff. Something you get to see in story mode. Maybe you'll be able to see it if you play as a Loti in multiplay. But for us, we can just advance on. There we go. So got a few more of these annoying turtles here. And these guys, oh, they are very annoying. They fire range shots, they attack quickly, they have blocks. They're spiked so you can't really jump on them. They're nuisances, but the good news is that they have relatively low health. Their attack is a little bit annoying though, just some moderate damage. If you move on over to this right side through single jumping apparently, you'll encounter another one of these guys, which we'll definitely take care of for some EXP, but otherwise this area bears no significance, as you can tell. Alright. Now let's move towards our left side now. And we'll prepare a charge attack before we drop down because we have three plant monsters to deal with here. And these guys get really annoying. Not only can they cast fire spells, but having three of these guys here casting slow spells which prevent you from healing and attacking very quickly, and a bunch of other garbage, can get a little bit annoying. So, it's always good to enter this area immediately with a charge attack. If you're smart, unlike me, you can come in here and spawn one at a time so you won't have to deal with three immediately. But otherwise, these guys are pretty run-of-the-mill. Pretty much identical to the guys we dealt with in Abyss's Forest, so nothing to worry about. By killing these three guys, we'll activate a switch that we can stand on in order to activate that purple platform in the back right there. And we can activate this switch in order to send that platform moving on up. Okay, let's recover some more SP, always keep on top of that. And we'll be doing that a lot as Selkies now because charged attacks are just simply fantastic. Now, I'm not sure if there's an enemy here. I don't think so. There we go. Break this barrel and we'll be able to get a few more fire magicites simply because I don't feel like moving my mouse over and dropping things down. And by activating the stand, we can lower the water level once more. If you want to get back up, just stand on this platform and you'll move back up. Pretty neat. Tiny little platform to hover up like 2 meters. I don't know. Anyways, we're landing in on the second last map already. Very short area. Let's move on over here and we can deal with the Sahagin 2 immediately. If I don't accidentally jump into the water, and apparently they're both going on land. This is terrible, actually. This is where my fate may die because they cast spell attacks. Very annoying ice ones, and there's 2 of them. Great. Alright, can I maybe like inch at one of these guys? It's actually a terrible idea. That spell is coming at me at like mock speed. Okay, I missed. Hold on. We can work on this. I'm willing to fire arrows at you once a day, just like nice and slowly here, just one by one. I have a tendency of drowning myself. What's wrong with me? Oh, come on, take it easy there. Ugh. All right, let's get away from this guy before something terrible happens. As you can tell, we're really lacking in health or defense right now. Not very good. If I really wanted to, I could do a bunch of runs of Mount Vow in order to get some health points. But I think I'll pass on that since that seems a little bit redundant since we're already going through these areas a bunch of times. Up ahead, we're going to deal with a few more of those turtle creatures, so stay prepared and keep those charge attacks ready. Alright, that's one down and there's another one up ahead, so... Oh, okay, 2 apparently. I miscounted. Okay, these guys. Come down. Relax. There we go. No, I actually haven't tried something here, and I'm actually going to try this method in a second. But first, let's take care of... Actually, let's just heal up our SP real quick, because I'm pretty sure I just saw a sentry spawn. I don't actually know their official name, so I'm not even going to bother with that. There we go, use our potions instead. And if I am correct... Yes, it's a robot, great. Annoying attacks, gotta keep moving. We're going to be using charge attacks mainly simply because I don't want to hang around this guy for too long. And we're given usually just enough time to get away from this guy before he attacks, so that's good. Alright. Stay away from me. And there we go, we got it down. Nice. Courageous weapon and iron. And we got another turtle around here. I'm going to try not to break this barrel, but no promises. Can I just Yeah, let's just... Yeah, get out of here. I'll deal with you later. Okay, so there's a permanent upgrade right around here, and I can show you. It's in that chest right there. The problem being is that I have no way... Okay, this guy is gonna... fix you right now. Fix you, send you into your grave. There we go. Alright, now, back to where we were. I have no idea how to get at that defense boost, which is in the chest, properly. Maybe we need to save both of these barrels right here. I'm gonna attempt this. Maybe a single jump? Okay, we're getting pretty close here. Maybe if I... let's nudge this up, but nudge this barrel on top of it a little bit forward. Maybe we'll be able to... Yeah, alright, so that's how you get a defense boost, legitimately. Apparently. Selkies, you know what to do. Alright, let's break these barrels and get ourselves some more supplies. And that's pretty much it for this part. Another thing to note is that there is one of those shenanigan elemental blue wispy wisp thingies for Lotis. If they're ever into that, I don't know. Alright, let's just hop on over here, another robot to deal with, but we're almost done. They look a little bit like those little electrical plugs in the United States and Canada. Alright, well, yeah, sure, whatever. If I plug you into a socket, do your legs just start whirling like a fan? Because that would be fantastic, actually. I don't even know why I came up with that. Anyways, wouldn't even be efficient. We took out everyone, and now there's two more stands. Make sure you have your magicites necessary. They gave you plenty in the past, so you won't be able to get very many here. I think you can only get blizzards, so that's something to keep in mind. Now, we're about to enter the boss, so I recommend you heal up before we get in there. And I want to remind you to stay calm, because we're going to be serving up sushi tonight. Or some stewy if you're into that. Now, this fish is very annoying and tedious, especially for every other class besides Selkies, but Selkies already have it pretty bad. Now let me switch over to my healing real quick and hopefully not get murdered by a giant fish already. Clearly, water is very effective against grass, somehow, in this universe. Okay, most people have to deal with this fish just by standing out around here and firing tacks in. Very annoying. Selkies, we're able to jump right on top of that fish and smack it right into crystal. So that's some good news. So let's try doing that. Or get knocked into the water. I don't know. Now, this fish will do an attack where it blows cold wind on you or something. And it can also shake you off. If you land into the water, begin mashing your jump button. And that way you'll be able to land with your feet up, so you can immediately dodge another attack. Because this fish has a tendency of comboing you if you don't do that. When you're laying on the ground, you're delayed for like a good second or two, and it's able to chain another attack, be it another crystal smack thing or a wind blowy thing. Just something you need to stay alert on. Also, be very, very liberal with your usage of healing items. Because if you get into one bad chain, you're gonna be dead pretty quickly. I'm pretty sure the other classes also have this pretty rough, and since I didn't do my jump properly, I'm gonna have to bear another attack, get stunned, and possibly get comboed again, so this is terrible. You know what, let's just heal before something happens, even if he attacks again. There you go, get on top of this fish. Yeah, smash it right in. Alright. It's really helpful to use a Selkie right here, because our range attacks are amazing. I'm pretty sure this arena is meant for Lotis to fire off a bunch of magicites into the fish tank. Terribly ineffective. Okay, landed upright, that's good. Heal, heal. Oh, the DS and the emulator have different healing buttons, which makes me so confused. Alright, we're almost done though. Since we're able to land consistent crystal shots, it's pretty good. Every other class, good luck. I think Yukes might have it a little bit easier. I don't know, maybe. They get the magicites, they can use their magic needle, which I can easily say as a very effective tribal ability. Probably the best, frankly. Well, excluding Lotis, but those aren't exactly attack tribal abilities. More like a support class, I guess. Alright, heal up. One more go, come on. Don't shake me off, there we go. And we're gonna take out the big one. All right. Gonna have sashimi for dinner today. Let's grab these things, perfect. And we still have quite a few healing items, so you know what? We'll do our speed run through of this area right away, just so we can get some extra supplies for crafting. So let's just do that. Now, a quick note is that a Selkie can actually get to the edge of... Okay, well, that failed miserably. A Selkie can get to the edge of the bridge, do a quick jump, have the... Why isn't this working? Ah! There we go, something like that. You get to the edge of the bridge, jump in. Once your feet touch the water, you want to do another double jump. For some reason, this isn't working as effectively as it used to be. Or at least as effective as the DS version was, but... Something to keep in mind. You know, I'm gonna do another quick run. I'm gonna do another run. I need to... Okay, hold on. Nah. Listen here, I need to redeem myself by drowning myself even more, but nonetheless. I'm gonna make sure I get a nice good running start, you know? You can't start a speed run like this, are you kidding me? Disappointing. Alright, straight down the center, into the water. Oh, there we go. Run straight ahead. There we go. I don't know why that was giving me so much trouble. I have never encountered that problem when I was playing this on my DS, so that's a little bit strange, but whatever. On the bright side, this area is short, relatively easy, and fighting the enemies aren't required, so we can get through this area pretty fast. Another thing is that we don't have to do that whole left window, right window, left window in order to get all the items now, since we can run past everyone. There we are. Let's push this control panel in, and this time we'll go into the entrance right below us, so you can see how that works. The good news is that I don't believe the Sahagans spawn immediately, so we won't have to worry too much about that either. We'll just stick to the corner here, grab the barrel, drop it down, run over here, grab the switch, do this, do that, and we're pretty much on our way. Great. Up right in here, safe zone. The good news is that we don't have to touch the crystal even. Run straight through to the other end. In here, the killing... We do have to kill the three mandatory plants though, so we'll do that right now. Oops, I missed. I don't even know how I did that, but I did. Avoid that slow attack there. There we go, another charge attack. I do find charge attacks more effective, but you can just do this if you're into it. There we go. Alright, I got hit by a fire attack, no problem. Can I get this down? There we go. Standing in the corner of this dark splotch in the ground will let you stand on the switch immediately and move it upwards. Switch on over here, grab my fire magicite. Usually if you're quick enough, you can actually just drop beyond this platform. And you can actually just hop into the water right away and move ahead if you're not into waiting. Alright, let's keep moving forward. Not the best speedrun. I think I do a lot better on the DS with this kind of stuff, but hey, what can you do, you know? Alright, let's keep on moving ahead, and now we can just double jump our way right across here. Don't even worry about that robot. Alright, one. And two. Oh, whoops. There we go, two. And let's hop right down. I'm really glad there's no, like, cutscene thingy that happens when we get rid of the waterfall, because that would be a little bit annoying, but we can hop right into the fish boss again. Alright. Out of the river and into the ocean. That doesn't make sense. I'm pretty sure one is freshwater and the other is saltwater, but nonetheless, still applies. Alright, let's take care of this fishy monster here. Something's fishy about this guy. I remember seeing him before. Those same cold dead fish eyes. Ah, okay, knocked into the water, mash B. Alright, land right on top. Beat up, that's good. Alright, work back on this crystal. Heal. You can heal on the fish. If you're drowning, you can heal. Presuming you're standing up, just in case, if you're low on health. Don't lose hope, is all I'm trying to say with this area. It's very much possible. Just make sure to mash your jump button the moment you get hit by that fish, and that way you'll be able to avoid any other chain combos. I know I had a very rough time dealing with this fish boss my first time around when I was playing this in story mode. I think I actually got so mad I just stopped playing Ring of Fates for a while because of it. I had like 5 game overs. As a result, I decided to actually leave, grind, come back in here. Still died like crazy, but I believe I finished it off by playing as a Yuke. That's the reason why I think Yuke's can actually do this boss relatively easy. I remember having the Clavat just get completely mashed in. Yuri had a rough time because he was a pure melee character. I think there's still equal opportunity though by standing on the platforms in the outer rim, or just the ground in the outer rim. You should be able to still get attacks in by luring him inwards, but you don't get to do as many dodges like double jumping or avoiding it altogether. You're often trapped in a corner with that stupid like wind attack that it has. Lotis, I never even bothered because, oh, that was so annoying to deal with. Switching in and out of your tribal ability was not very effective, and even in the second fish boss fight, it still wasn't effective, but we're pretty much good here. I don't know if this was faster than my last attempt on the boss, but not too concerned, presuming as long as I don't die again, that will be great, because I'm not too interested in having a double death today, but this fish really wants it apparently, so I'd rather play it safe, frankly. There we go. Come on, fish, get back up here. Yeah, no. Okay, where am I? Other end of the pond. Fantastic. Get on this guy. Oh, come on. Shaking me off immediately? That's ridiculous. Alright. Just gonna land a smack on you because I apparently can't jump on you with your mouth gaping open like a moron. Oh, more bubble attacks. Underwater attacks are very annoying. The bubbles are relatively easy to dodge, might be a little bit harder if you're not able to double jump because you're not playing as a Selkie. There's so many reasons to play as a Selkie. I don't know why you would not play as a Selkie in multiplay. Maybe because you like other tribal abilities? I don't know. Double jumping is amazing. Lets you skip so much of the areas, it makes grinding not a problem, and it's the reason why I can play multiplay over and over again, because if I'm just really lazy one day, I can just do the so to say speedrun version of it and, you know, just call it a day. Alright, we're almost out of cure magicites, but this boss is almost out of health. So nothing to worry about. There we are, get fish smashed, and it's gone. You can actually stand on a bed of items in order to not drown. So that's something to do if you're into surfing items. Kind of a strange hobby if that's the thing you're up for, but sometimes items get stuck in these platforms. I've encountered this at least, but it doesn't seem like it. Anyways, let's move on. We're good to go. We're done with Rela, Cyel. And 32 minutes, that's significantly faster than before. And I don't think there's very much dialogue to go around here. Do you say anything new? No. I believe it's still only in the like Selkiest section of this area. Alright, what do you three have to say? Why'd everybody have to come back from their quest so soon? Right when I thought we'd caught a break. Maybe they're scared somebody's gonna scold them mercilessly just like Shish does to us. I heard every word. Be afraid. Okay, nothing new from you guys, I guess. Just like that, great. What about you two?
Ugh, the nerve of that guy! Who does he think he is, calling my hairstyle frumpy? No dweeb with a two-gill haircut and no fashion sense whatsoever is telling me how to wear my hair.
Jeez, you're really independent about this.
The town's perking up little by little. Maybe they'll even have a festival, and that mean...
Nope, let's not do that.
And I think that's pretty much it for dialogue. We can just do a quick wander around town to make sure.
Yeah, I don't really think there's anything new here.
That's fine though.
Alright, well, let's go into the Mogmart then and do some business. Yeah! Alright, what do we have here? SP boost? We can use that. Why not? Bunch of pockets! I'll take all of these actually, that seems pretty good.
We already have quite a few items in stock though. I'd rather have a bunch of the cure pockets, maybe an ether pocket or two, because we're kind of running out on those, but it's apparent that we won't be getting any.
Clear pockets are nice, but I'm not a fan of casting two magicites in a go and trying to combo those spells because, you know, I don't get a fast ring lock or anything like that.
Hello, Chappie! What do we have here?
Alright, let's switch into- Let's sort by weapons, and what do we have here? Fiery, icy, we've done that before, thunderous, courageous weapon, and magical weapons. Let me buy a tree branch real quick. And I'm not really sure what weapon I want. Oh, right. Stuff here, too. Okay, let's get a ruby. And let's get our amethysts, which will provide us abilities.
ability upgrades. Oak branches, I think it was oak branches. We'll get some of these here. And yeah, we can play around with some weaponry. I think the courageous weapon is probably the way to go since I want attack. Okay, it's tree branches. Hold on. You know, I'm going to make one either or because I want to see what's going on, what's coming out of this, you know? So, tree branches. Give me some tree branches. There we go. All right. Listen, for how short this episode was, I'll make it up to you guys by fumbling with these menus over and over again. So, let's make sure we get what we want first. The courageous weapon. We'll do a... No, we'll go with a ruby. I have a feeling this thing probably doesn't provide any real skill benefits. We got a ranger's bow. Alright. Monk wisdom. This went down. Was this not the equipment I was supposed to have? Ranger's bow? Was it what? Oh, it's because that thing that has like an attack bonus. Okay, never mind. Hold on. Let's make another one. We'll try an amethyst this time. I don't know how many I have though, so hopefully we don't run out. Attack bonus. Okay, this is a lot better. Alright, yeah, we'll take that. Cool. And magical weapon, we'll wait on that first because I want to see what we have here. Knight's helm, fire hat, thunder hat. What is this? Is this a yellow cone hat and an orange cone hat? Red cone hat, stuff like that? Orange cone hat, right. I think I want the cone hats actually because they provide a nice attack bonus. We'll actually check with the armory on that before we do anything. Knight's helmet will provide defense, but I'm not really interested in that right now, so... Let's see here. Yeah, we got all the equipment we want. Band of security, rebirth. Is this the skill ring or the life ring? That's the life ring. Okay, we're not interested in that. Ice Covenant is... What is this? This is an Azure Crest. Alright, don't care. Cool. Yeah, let's check the armory real quick. Alright, what do you have for sale? Cool, we haven't checked in you for a while. Make sure our weapons are in line. Killer bow, yep. War bow, ranger bow. Okay, so that's what we're supposed to have right now. For head armor, we have our orange cone hat, which provides... Okay, that's no attack bonus. One attack bonus, and yellow. Alright, so we're going for yellow, apparently. And is this the same thing here? Silver corselet for defense. And the knight armor for something. I don't even know where you get the silver corselet, frankly. So, yeah, we'll go for some yellow outfit stuff. Which is thunder, skill ring, something that will... have to craft ourselves in the future. So there we go. Let's move on over here and actually make the stuff we want. Okay, where is it? Thunder hat. All right, that's one of the items. Let us stack a something that we don't really care about. So maybe an onyx. Why not? What's an onyx going to do to this hat? We're going to get a bunch of unnecessary things. Fantastic. At least our attack goes up. That's all I care about, really. And let's see here, thunderous garb, that's what we wanted. And you know, I don't know what a citrine does, but let's put one of these here. I'm not going to use the sapphire because that's obviously magic. And we're going to get red mage wisdom. I don't think that benefits me really, but sure. This lowers my attack by 5? No way. Oh, dang it, I don't really want that then. Do I want, you know, let's just play the... play the roulette again. Here, we'll put a nice amethyst in there. Maybe we'll be able to get something nice. Come on. No. Yeah, whatever. We might as well wear a full set of equipment then. Why not? We already got our attack bonus from the hat, so that evens out, I guess. I think this means we end up where we started, but sure. Okay, well, I think I'm just playing in the menus right now. Let's just play around with items. Why not? I have a bunch of this stuff. Amethyst, get me something nice, please. Power ring, attack bonus, and dragoon lore. Is this the exact same? Oh my gosh, okay, don't equip that. Advanced rank, mystique, magic ring, security, defense ring? What? Defense ring? Do those even exist? Apparently they do. No, I think I'm just having short-term and long-term memory loss right now. So enough playing around with the menus. Let's just go do a quest before it's too... magical weapons, I forgot. Hold on. The memory loss is back. Alright, magical weapons. Cool, let's make one of these things. What do we have here? Sapphire? Amethyst? Fuck it, we'll put a sapphire on this real quick. Alright, what do we get? Elfin bow? Yeah, I figured I didn't want this darn thing. Cool, let's junk that. It's fine, at least we made it. Let's go. Jeez. With me fumbling around, this video is going to end up at an hour again. But, Listen, don't worry about it. You guys say anything new? No, you don't. Alright, whatever. Let's do a quest. What do we have here? Tough cookies? Nah. Invisible stalkers. Defeat all invisible monsters. Monsters are only visible through players who are carrying the crystal or through a Yuke's tribal ability. I remember this. This quest is miserable. I am going to get a game over on this quest. Let's do it! So, despite this quest being a one-player quest as well, you pretty much want two players for it, and you'll see why in a second. The strangest thing has happened. Some soldiers claimed they were attacked by invisible monsters. Ordinarily, I'd brush off news like that so much as rubbish, but soldiers have been wounded. I'd like to enlist your aid in subduing these unseen enemies. These soldiers who got away safely brought back this odd device with the crystal embedded in the center. According to them, you can see the enemies only when someone holds the device over his head. With effective use of this tool, it becomes possible to defeat an invisible foe. Why can't these monsters find a better use for their obviously amazing ability? What a waste. Now, if I had that ability to make myself invisible, you can be sure I wouldn't go... This is no time for us to be prattling on about nothing. Hustle out there and make care of this monster mess. Take care of this. Alright, anyways, I think you can already get the idea of why this is miserable for us. One, we're not a Yuke, and two, if we're carrying a crystal, we can't exactly attack these guys. As you can see right here, and you get like reduced damage, don't you? Actually, that doesn't seem very reduced. Okay, maybe we can actually do this. Let's give this a go. We'll use my amazing echolocation to deal with these guys. Echolocation right there. Alright, so we might actually be able to do this. Alright, okay, never mind. If there's an ice bomb up ahead, we're screwed. There we go. Oh, got it. Kill it, kill it, kill it, fuck it, run, run, run! Don't blow up! Okay, we're good. That was nerve-wracking. Let's switch over to our potions real quick before something bad happens. On the bright side, it seems like we don't have a time limit. Probably for the best. Okay, you're probably doing your fire attack. Are you right here? On the bright side, we do have a tri-arrow attack, which is very beneficial to us. We're able to figure out where these guys are. Oh my god! Okay. Whoa, hey, take it easy there. Yeah, let's just launch it. Okay, nope. If I hear a beeping noise, I'm running away. Yep, I hear a beeping noise. Screw that. I'm running away. Please don't kill me. There we go. Running a little bit low on supplies. Getting a little bit annoyed that I have to keep moving my hand over to go collect magicites and stuff. Princess Insignia? Oh boy, we get to wear a crown in the future, I guess. Something neat. Throw this away. Okay, that's right there. Go in here, zap, 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 zap. Alright, cool, we did it. Give me that magicite. Yeah, I deserve that. Stage complete. Let's move on to the next one, please. Oh no, switches and everything. Wait, what's happening here? Where is this? Alright, there's the crystal. Apparently we get two around here. Alright, we got a fire moo. And another fire moo. Okay, that's fine. Let's just put this right here and take care of these guys. We have 6 enemies. 12 enemies. Can't read. Great. That's no good. Alright, these two are down and we're going to get a redstone out of it. Not exactly the best, but okay. Alright, stomp on this. Apparently that doesn't matter. Too bad! I'm a Selkie, I can double jump. Okay, let's take care of you. Apparently you're stuck in this corner. What's going on here, bat? Ah, I fell. Okay, well, that helps me a lot, actually. Never mind. No, it doesn't. You're gone. Are you here? I have no... Okay, there we go. We got the hit. Great. Let's just hop on ahead, then. And we'll just grab this crystal here. Oh, my God. Okay. Yeah, that's a move. And that is a terrible spell attack. Are you here? Are you here? Where's that move? Oh, there's two. Okay. Is this what it's like to be in constant paranoia? Maybe. Got another bat over here. Alright, cool. Hello. Please don't cast terrible spells on me. Where are you? There we go. This is actually going pretty well right now, I must say. I remember doing a test run of this before, or something like that. and just getting my butt handed to me. Oh, no, this is where it happens, isn't it? Great. All right. Okay, we'll just keep using echolocation. Attack-o-location? Yeah. We'll use silky echolocation, which is basically firing arrows at the enemy to gauge how close they are. Too close! Too close! Oh my god, okay. This is the real horror film right here. This is a horror game to its truest nature. Alright, you little butt over there. Invincibility! Come at me, you fool! Ugh, yeah, eat my criticals! Goddamn right. Cool. Alright. Did I throw the rock away? Where is it? Oh, hey, cool. Hello, rock. Invincibility is great, is all I'm saying. I don't think you can actually get this through a spell combination or a magicite combination in the actual game, which is a shame. But hey, still pretty good whenever you can get access to that. What's in here? Cool, I didn't want that. Where is this? Okay. Yep, there we go. That's what we wanted. I guess it's not what we wanted. Cool, I'm sure there's enemies around here. We'll just fire arrows off in the middle of nowhere. Hello? Hello? Is it this? Is this what I need to touch? Is something like watching me right now? Oh, okay, there's an enemy here. Oh god, it's a bomb, isn't it? It's definitely a bomb. I'm out of here. Okay, we'll get a rock. We'll get a rock. Clearly this is taking too much time. We're sitting at 46 minutes. I expected this video to be like 40 maximum. As you can tell, I'm not very good with managing my time. It's a good thing that I don't split these videos into 24-minute parts, because that would be very annoying for me to render, and probably for you guys, since you would watch 5 videos of me and— oh my gosh, being in the same area. Selkie echolocation. Alright, too close. Alright, something's ticking, so I'm just gonna get up here. Alright, what is that? Is that still the bomb? Yes, it is. Okay, cool. Throw you down here. Take care of this moo. There we go. Yeah, nice and slowly. The end is near. I'm hopping out of here. Okay. Yes, we did it! Yay! Alright, there we go. Quest completed. Yeah. Come claim your prizes. Go! Yes, what do we get? Oh, garbage right in front of us. We got a reddish emblem, a potion, heavenly specs. Just one of these materials, really, a garnet. Okay, that's not really good. Right, we're done with this area, aren't we? Cool. I made a bunch of items in this video. There's a ton of recipes I haven't touched yet. We'll probably, like, I don't really know what the princess insignia goes with. I know it's a crown. I've used it before, so I guess we'll probably just, like, pair that up with the silver corselet. In the at the end of the video. And then I think everything else should be just fine, because I can buy it from the store if I need them, and I'm pretty sure I have the materials to craft that stuff, so that's pretty good. And we managed to get a few more cure pockets. I'm glad we're in the 20 level now. It's pretty good. What do you have to say for yourself? Well, of course you won't say anything. Anyways, I think that's pretty much it. Don't think I missed anything. Thank you for watching this episode of Ring of Fates. In the next one, we head over to Killanda Isle. See you then!